If you're like me, then you may have just started out writing code with whatever text editor or IDE that your teacher used or your first tutorial used, and then not really given it much thought after that. And now, after coding for a little bit, you're starting to question whether that was actually the right choice. Well, don't worry, because you've come to the right place. This will be my complete guide to help you choose which text editor to make your weapon of choice. First question that we need to answer is what text editors are actually out there, and Stack Overflow really helps us here because they did a poll in 2019 of over 87,000 developers asking which text editor they use most commonly. The most commonly used one is Visual Studio Code with 50.7%, and in second place we have Notepad++ with 30.5%, and in third place we have Vim with 25.4%. Fourth place goes to Sublime Text with 23.4%. And lastly, we have Atom with 13.3%. These are the top 5 text editors that people use. And this poll also took in IDEs, but I excluded them since this video is about text editors only. So these were the editors that most people like and use. Now let's move on to what to consider when choosing a text editor. First off, the learning curve. For instance, with a text editor like Vim, which is a really popular one, there is one drawback, and that is the learning curve. Vim uses a ton of key bindings for navigation and for writing and editing text. In order to use Vim, you need to first learn how to write text, how to stop writing text, how to save, and finally how to quit. With all the other editors mentioned, you don't need to learn any of these things because you will already know how to do it since they work like pretty much everything else that you're used to. This means that the learning curve for using Vim is a lot greater than it is for any of the other editors on our list, but the potential for productivity benefits that this can lead to are also a lot greater. Since Vim is based around being a fast editor, it means that making changes to text should be as quick as possible. It is optimized for using the keyboard as your only input device, and once you get the hang of that, you can be way faster because you never have to touch your mouse.
Most text editors have keyboard shortcuts and key bindings for different things, but they're not really optimizing for it, which means that they're not doing it nearly as well as Vim does it. But what they do have, on the other hand, is a really nice user interface that pretty much anyone can use that has spent any time with a computer. So it's kind of a lot easier to use out of the box, but with this ease of use, it kind of has to drop a lot of the features that Vim's complexity kind of allows. So therefore, I would say that Vim is for the person who gets turned on by key bindings and who's excited by the thought of spending a week or two reading documentation in order to like maximally exploit their editor of choice. And also for the person who kind of likes to think of themselves as a hardcore coder, because Vim will make you both look and feel hardcore.
Next thing to look at is capabilities. And here we have Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code is probably the master when it comes to capabilities. It's the all-in-one package. This is the editor that most programmers seem to use for most of their programming. And this is for good reason.
All right, so on the topic of text editors, I wanted to share with you the sponsor for today's video, which is a tool that will help you write faster code in any of the text editors that I've mentioned in this video. This video is sponsored by Kite.
Kite is a free auto-completion engine that uses machine learning to provide the completions, which is what makes it stand out, and also what makes it the best auto-completion engine that I've used. One of the most useful features is that Kite's completions are sorted or ranked by relevance instead of by popularity or by the alphabet. This is possible because they're using machine learning to provide the completions. It means that you will get suggested completions based on the code that you're actually writing. And if you're writing code in Python, the Copilot feature offers documentation lookup, so you don't have to constantly Google search function signatures and call patterns. With Kite, you can actually write code up to 18% faster, and who doesn't want to write code faster, right? So I highly recommend that you download Kite and try it out. It's completely free and supports up to 13 programming languages and 16 IDEs. So just give it a go. I know that you will like it because I love it.
To me, VS Code is one of those text editors that when I'm using it, I'm not really reflecting over the fact that I'm in a text editor. I don't really have any questions and I can just work and it just works, except for the super annoying update and extension reminders that are constantly popping up in the bottom corner. But that's probably just something that I could turn off in the settings if I could be bothered to do so. VS Code is the editor that I just naturally find myself opening up whenever I'm working on a bigger project. It has an extensive library of extensions that can help you be more efficient with pretty much any project that you could come up with. VS Code has Git integration, terminal console integration, memory consumption is low, and even on bigger projects, it runs really smoothly. And these things are not unique to VS Code. They also exist in other editors. However, with Atom, for instance, you have to install a terminal in order to use it. And with Sublime, you need to install a package for Git integration. And even with that, it just doesn't work as smoothly as with VS Code.
Although that's just my opinion, and there's probably tons of Sublimists and Atomists out there who would argue that their way of doing things is way better, and they may be right, but to me it just seems too complex, and especially for beginners, where I think that the value of it just works is something that can't really be underestimated. And I think that VS Code is exactly that, it just works. And it seems to have all the things that you need, and the implementation of those things is easy to use and easy to understand.
Next we have speed, and here I think the winner is Sublime Text. The speed you need. No, wait, that's OnePlus's slogan. Anyway, you get the point. It's fast, it's lightweight, it's what I would call the ultimate starter editor. If you're just getting started, then Sublime Text is likely a great choice because it's lightweight and fast, so you can try things out really quickly and test your code without a lot of extra stuff that something more fleshed out like VS Code, Atom, or Notepad++ will come with. Sublime is ideal for two people, the absolute beginner and the fairly advanced.
So what do I mean with it being ideal for both the advanced programmer and the beginner programmer? It seems kind of contradictory, right? Well, not really. And this ties into my fourth point, which is maybe you should use two text editors.
A lot of more advanced programmers will actually tell you that they use two editors, or at least some do. The reason for this is if you're working on something that's really big, then starting up VS Code just to change a single line of code in the entire project is kind of a waste of time. So in that case, some programmers will have a faster editor for quick fixes or small changes. Vim is a really great example, but again requires some getting used to. So a fairly common combo that I've used and also seen other people use is VS Code as the main editor and Sublime Text for quick fix small edits. The reason is that VS Code can become a little bit slower, especially if the project is quite large. So then it makes total sense to use something that is faster and more lightweight for any smaller changes that you need to make.
This is why I think that Sublime Text is perfect for the beginner programmer and the advanced programmer, because the use case for both will be very similar, even though their experience level differ greatly. And the beginner will basically be working on probably just one file essentially and writing very small scripts. And in that case, using something like VS Code kind of almost becomes overkill. Whereas the advanced programmer, they may be working on really big files or really big projects with lots of different files in them. But maybe right before they go to lunch, their boss asks them to fix a line of code in one of the projects. And in that case, opening up the entire project just becomes something that's like really unnecessary to do. So the advanced programmer may want to just open up a single file and make that quick edit and then head off to lunch. And in that case, Sublime Text is perfect.
So now what editors have I used? Well, this is exactly what I've used in the past. VS Code for my main projects and longer sessions, and Sublime Text for my shorter, quick fix, fast coding sessions. And honestly, this is something that came to me quite naturally, and it came from the want to use Sublime Text because I like their style a lot more. But for some reason, as soon as it was a bigger project, I always ended up switching back from Sublime Text to VS Code after an hour or so. And I'm not really certain why exactly that is, but something just made me do that naturally.
Same goes for the opposite direction, of course. Anytime I started writing something small in VS Code, I would just end up going over to Sublime Text because VS Code just felt too big for what I was doing. Kind of overkill in a way. So now finally, what text editor am I actually using? And right now I'm getting my feet kind of wet with Vim, and I can use it to write and edit text quite well, but I haven't gotten around to learning how to navigate between different files. So I mostly use it for smaller projects right now, where it's like a hack where it's just gonna be like one file that I'm gonna be editing. And if I'm doing something where it's gonna be several different files,
then I'm probably going to be using something like Sublime Text. And the reason that I'm using Sublime over VS Code is that I generally don't have that many files in my projects, unless I'm doing something like Flutter. If I do a Flutter project, then I'll be using VS Code, but usually it's going to be Sublime Text and Vim. That's going to be the text editors that I'm using. And I'm getting to learning how to navigate between different files, I promise. All right, so in conclusion, the best text editor for programming goes to the people's choice and my choice, which is VS Code. It does it all, it does it well, and it does it better. And my honorary mention goes to Sublime Text for just being so fast and such a joy to use. Everything about it just feels fast and lightweight, and that's why I personally love it. And I want to mention that the reason that I didn't talk too much about, or basically at all, about Atom or Notepad++ is because I feel like they don't differentiate themselves enough. They are technically slightly better than Sublime Text, but they're not quite as good as VS Code. And I feel like they don't have a strong selling point in that sense, because they're not as lightweight and fast as Sublime Text, but they're not as complete as VS Code. So they kind of end up in that like middle ground where they're not this and they're not that. So they're really good for like one text editor. But my main argument in this video is basically, I think you should use two text editors. One that's really complete and that has all the features that you need, and one that's really lightweight and fast that you can use for just quick edits and quick fixes. So I hope that I did a fair comparison of all of these text editors. I've done a lot of research to try to make sure that I did a fair comparison, but there's probably something that I missed. So if there's something that I missed that you feel I should have mentioned, feel free to let me know. I really appreciate that. But I hope I was able to give you some insight into what text editor to choose, and I hopefully made your decision a little bit easier. And that's basically it for this one. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope I'll see you in the next one tomorrow.